White House Hotel on the very happy occasion of their marriage. I'm sure that it means a great deal to them that you are here to share in their happiness and celebrate with them the beginning of their married life together. Apart from Simon, Bethany and Chris, would you all now please be seated? My name is Harry Towne. It's my great pleasure and my privilege to be conducting the ceremony here today on behalf of Norfolk Registration Service. I would like to also introduce my colleague Tina Rivett, who will register the marriage and ensure that all the legal formalities are completed correctly. Can I start by asking who gives Bethany to be married to Simon?
I do.
Simon and Bethany, before you are joined in marriage, I should remind you both of the solemn and binding nature of the vows you are about to make. Marriage in this country means the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life to the exclusion of all others. It is a promise of hope between two people who love each other, to share their love and friendship, and to offer help and comfort in times of joy and in times of sorrow. Simon and Bethany will now declare there is no legal reason why they should not marry. So Simon, please answer the following question by saying, I am. Are you Simon Spencer Kemp, legally free to marry Bethany Ray Wright?
I am.
Again, answer by saying I am. Are you Bethany Ray Wright, legally free to marry Simon Spencer Kemp?
I am.
Turn and face each other as we come to your contracting words. If you'd like to take each other's hands. And this time, Simon, please repeat after me and say it to your bride. I, Simon Spencer Kemp.
I, Simon Spencer Kemp.
Take you, Bethany Ray Wright.
Take you, Bethany Ray Wright.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
Again, Bethany, repeat after me to your husband. I, Bethany Ray Wright.
I, Bethany Ray Wright.
Take you, Simon Spencer Kemp.
Take you, Simon Spencer Kemp.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Simon, do you take Bethany to be your wife and do you promise to be loving, caring and loyal to her for the rest of your life together?
I do.
Bethany, do you take Simon to be your husband and do you promise to be loving, caring and loyal to him for the rest of your life together?
I do.
Thank you. So you can relax now, because at this point in the ceremony, ladies and gentlemen, we have a reading which is going to be given for us by Marissa.
Always be as close and as happy as today, yet be secure enough to grow and change along the way. If you can keep for you alone your love as man and wife, yet find the time to share your joy with others in your life. If you can be as one and walk through marriage hand in hand, yet still support the goals and dreams that each of you has planned. If you can dare to go your separate ways together, then all the wonder of today will stay with you forever.
Thank you very much. Simon and Bethany have chosen to demonstrate their commitment by the giving and the receiving of rings. A wedding ring is a symbol of the everlasting circle of love, truth and unity in which two lives are joined together. So Paul, if you'd like to come up and present the bride's ring to the groom. Place it halfway down the ring finger and hold it there whilst you repeat after me. Bethany, I give you this ring.
Bethany, I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my love.
Of my love.
And to show.
And to show.
That I choose you.
That I should choose you.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
Today and always.
Today and always.
Put the ring finger on. Thank you very much. And Rob, would you please present the bride with the groom's ring? And again, halfway down the ring finger. And hold it there whilst you repeat after me. Simon, I give you this ring.
Simon, I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of my love.
Of my love.
And to show.
And to show.
That I choose you.
That I choose you.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
Today and always.
Today and always.
So may these rings always remind you both of the promises you have made to each other today. Marriage will be the start of a new beginning and a new phase in your life together. Your marriage will call for cooperation, friendship, and mutual respect. It also needs understanding, patience, honesty, and a good sense of humour. It will require devotion, the ability to listen, the wisdom to know when you are wrong, and the willingness and strength to put things right. Today will be a milestone in your lives which you can look back on with happiness and pride. From this day, may the ordinary things you share become special and the special things become great. Cherish your love for each other, enhance the potential you have as individuals and as a couple, and look to the future with a commitment that grows deeper and stronger as the years pass. Simon and Bethany, you have both demonstrated your commitment to each other in the presence of your guests here today. Congratulations to you both. You may now kiss your bride. Gentlemen, at this point in the ceremony, we're going to make our way into Lenwade House for the legal aspect of the ceremony, and that will be the bride, the groom, the two witnesses, and their parents. So if you'd just like to enjoy yourselves until we return, we will return.
Talking to the songbird yesterday, flew me to a place not far away. She's a little pilot in my mind, singing songs of love to pass the time. Gonna write a song so she can see, give her all the love she gives to me. Talk of better days that have yet to come, never felt this love from anyone. She's not anyone. She's not anyone. She's not anyone. A man can never dream these kind of things, especially when she came and spread her wings. Whispered in my ear the things I'd like, then she flew away into the night. Gonna write a song so she can see, give her all the love she gives to me. Talk of better days that have yet to come, never felt this love from anyone. She's not anyone. She's not anyone. She's not anyone.
Come a little bit closer, hear what I have to say.
Woo!
Just like children sleeping, we could dream this night away. There's a full moon rising, let's go dancing in the light. Nowhere the music's playing, let's go out and feel the light. I'm still in love with you. I wanna see you dance again. Yes, I'm still in love with you. On this harvest moon, when we were strangers, I watched you from afar. When we were lovers, I loved you. It's getting late, and the moon is climbing high. I wanna celebrate, see it shining in your eyes. I'm still in love with you. I wanna see you dance again, 'cause I'm still in love with you. On this harvest moon, I'm still in love with you. I want to see you dance again, 'cause I'm still in love with you. On this harvest moon, I've been in search of stones, making up the pavement. Let's travel roads, mining for treasure deep in my bones that I never found. Went looking for evidence, tried to find it in the bottle. Came back again, high on a hash pipe of good intent. It only brought me down. Tried institutions of the mind and soul. It only taught me what I should not know. dance well, who would have guessed? Could be something as simple as this. Something as simple as this. Travel to each ocean's end. Saw seven wonders, trying to make some sense. Memorize the mantra Confucius said, but it only let me down. Tried absolution of the mind and soul. It only led me where I should not go. So well, how could I miss something as simple as this? Something as simple as this. I've been falling, crashing, breaking, and all the while you stood here waiting for me, girl. Tried liberation of my own free will, but let me look into get higher still. Oh, and the answer, well, who could have guessed? Could be something as simple as this. God knows how I could have missed something as simple.
I never thought I'd miss you half as much as I do.
Simon and Bethany, Peter and Margaret, Kay and myself would all like to welcome you all to thank you for being here today. It's very special for all sharing this with us today. You will notice that the wedding has a certain travel theme associated with it, which is very apt, as there are some of you that have travelled a long distance today. And I have some figures for you. 5,424. That's the distance in miles Jamie has travelled from Hokkaido, Japan, for appearance today. Wow. Nice to see you. But that's not the furthest. 10,370 is the distance that Clinton and Margaret have travelled from Heathcote in Australia. And 41 is the distance from Lowestoft. All the way from crossing from Suffolk to Norfolk.
Thank you.
But I also like to mention here a few absent family. Sadly, neither Bethany's grandparents will be here today. And although whilst we can't see them and feel their presence, I think we'll find them. But when you look around you today, everything you see has a certain influence. It's from them. And I'd like you now to just raise your glasses in toast. Glass and glasses.
Is there any way down?
So when I sat down to write this speech last weekend on Lowestoft Beach, I pondered on words that I might need to describe how I would feel when I saw Bethany at 12 o'clock today. And I have to tell you that I find it because I cannot find the words to express how proud I felt when I saw her. But I'm proud of not just how beautiful she looks, I'm proud of her as a daughter. Bethany's always been something of a free spirit. And has always had such a wonderful energy that she applies to everything that she does. I recall a wedding some time ago when Bethany was 2 to 3 years old. And all of the other kids in the family were all lined up outside the church, all very neatly in their best. And Bethany, but Bethany didn't stand there. She decided to run. She made a dash for the wall. I ran after her, Kay ran after her, a couple of others, but none of us managed to stop her until she got to that wall. And she took off her hat, probably threw it into the road. And she was for some time in certain circles referred to as that Bethany. Kay and I have watched her grow and use that wonderful focus of energy in her career, her studies and in her life. And we're both extremely proud of everything that she's achieved today and, of course, how beautiful she looks today. Yeah. Which reminds me of 27 years ago when I married my wife. And I must say, looks as beautiful as stunning and stunning as she did. You will hopefully have all found a name mat. If you haven't, you're sitting at the wrong table. Bethany's asked me to mention this because she spent a lot of time, probably around 1 hour, and each one has been like 50 minutes, 1 hour. Each one has been drawn out by hand with help from Jenny and Kay, and then carved with a hot knife and varnish. So she just wanted me to mention this to make sure that you took the home with you tonight. In fact, you can't get out until you've shown her. So 5 years, sorry, 7 years ago, Bethany brings this guy, Simon. He's a smart looking chap, well spoken. He likes football. He supports the team in Hungary. Same as me. So you're on. He has an impeccable taste in music, similar to my own. So is this guy perfect? Is he absolutely 100% perfect? No. Have you ever seen him hold a pen? But seriously, I've spent a lot of time with Simon. We've been to gigs, festivals, football matches together, and I enjoy his company immensely. I couldn't be a happier man than giving my hand to him today. And it's not that I'm losing a daughter, it's that I'm gaining an electrician. Tells me that I should offer Simon some advice. So it's quite simple. It's five words you have to learn. A successful marriage. And those five words are, I'm sorry, it's my fault. You remember those, that's all you need to know. So that really leaves me the only task to ask you to stand. And to toast Bethany and Simon to their ongoing happiness.
Thanks ever so much. We've got a little gift for your mother. You've made me feel part of the family from day one. It certainly is a laugh a minute with you guys. No one's perfect, some of you support Ipswich. A special mention to Jane for all her hard work at the table decorations. Jane, where are you? As for my family, always their support and help us. I mean, the garden looks great. Me and Beth don't even touch it. So thanks, Dad, for that. I guess you could describe me as a pain in the arse when I was a kid, but hopefully you've directed me down the right path. You've got me to this point, so thanks ever so much. We've got a gift for flowers. Right, okay, another special mention for Jamie Kemp again, who's making his way to gate 530 at the airport. Probably thought, Jesus, I hope it's going to be worth it. I hope it is. Enjoy your day. Right, on to the bridesmaids, okay. I'm sure you all agree that looked amazing today. Thanks for your efforts for today and organising Best Madrid Hen Do. Special thanks to Jenny, who organised so many events there. Nearly. To the bridesmaids, please. Also, I want to thank Jack and Chris for being the assets for the day. We've got a little supper for you. If you want to come up. And also, I want to thank Bob and Paul for being my best men. We've got a little gift for you as well. We'll just pass along there. Right, there's just one more person to thank. My beautiful wife, Beth. Changed my life. I mean, if we could get along wearing the same clothes and sleeping in the camper van for weeks on end, we'd make it work. Love you to bits. A toast to my beautiful wife, Beth. Right, without further notice, let me introduce my two best men. Childhood friend, best striker in Helsinki history, all-round good family guy, Rob Van. Again, childhood friend, my electrical mentor, and a northern wannabe, Paul Spick.
Right, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you all have an enjoyable day so far. Simon was best man for both our weddings, so as well as being an honour and a pleasure, it seemed quite fitting that we've been asked to be here today. So cheers, mate.
Before we start our speech, I think we'd like to say how stunning the bridesmaids look all of today. I think you all agree. It's word of warning though, just stay clear of our mate Nelson. How stunning Beth looks today. You all agree that he's definitely punched the brother.
known Simon since we were about 7. And we spent all our childhood together. We went to the same school, played for the same football team, and went to the same public house. We spent probably too much time and too much money. Regarding the football, I think we both met Simon playing for Helston Football Club. Simon was a baby-faced, nippy left winger who was very quiet and kept himself to himself. Oh, how things change. Towards the end of his career, he played left-back for Helston men's side. Any winger or striker, what got past him, ran like Usain Bolt, just trying to save their legs. I contacted Norfolk FA today, and they told me that they had the biggest funds from football offences by Simon Clay. So I'd just like to say thank you very much for that.
Going back a few years now, you said you've been with Beth, there's a seven or so years. Yeah. I think I was with Simon the first ever time he met Beth, the first ever time, but we see her on a bus on the way home from the city. obviously, it was a night out on a drink and that, so we were on there. He walked down, stumbled down to the front of the bus to speak to Beth and one of her friends, I'm not sure who it was at the time, one of her friends, chatting up for about 10 or 10 minutes. And we got off the bus at the Bull, with a nightcap in the Bull. Unfortunately for Simon, best friend's brother was in there, and he'd heard about Simon's bad chat-up, and end up in a bit of a fight. The same fella actually came to the stag do with us the other week, and he will be here later. Which is why I asked earlier if his sister was going to be here today. Another story going back, a good 12 years, when I first left home to live with my wife and Lisa. I lived in Sproston, and Kevin would tend to come round and stay around the odd weekend, and one weekend we come home on a Saturday night after another session of sea, which we used to always do on Saturday night. We had a nightcap, and all we had was a bottle of red wine without a bottle opener. It's the only way we can get this bottle of red wine was with a knife. So we stabbed the bottle of red wine and we sprayed the ceiling, which wasn't too good. They'd also tend to stay in my bed as well, which also annoyed my wife Lisa. Be on settee and me and Kemby would be in bed. But there was one occasion we had a party around Lisa's for her birthday one year at a barbecue, and got early hours in the morning, decided he wanted to go to bed again, so he went and made his way upstairs, tried to get into bed, my mother-in-law's bed. Not realising that my mother-in-law was in the bed at the time. That didn't go down too well.
Right, now it's my turn then. My first story goes back about 8 years, when me and my wife-to-be, Vicky, went out for dinner and decided to call in the local pub for a couple of jars. Some of the lads, including Simon, were in the vicinity after a few drinks. Vic and Simon somehow ended up having a tequila slammer contest. However, this was the first time Simon had met Vic, so it was a bit weird. The slammers and pints flowed freely all night. The end result was to call it a draw. And we walked back to the flats where we were both living. All seemed well. However, I later learned Simon had redecorated his bathroom with vomit, which was so bad he had to chuck half it away, including bath mats and everything else in there. So I would say that's 1-0 to Vic. Flash forward a few years later, Simon, Beth, and Vic and myself went to Tenerife for a bit of winter sun. It was a great holiday, loads of laughs and fun had. And to this day, he remains the only person I know to dislocate his shoulder while wrestling an inflatable crocodile. God knows how he survived travelling the world in 2012. In the same holiday, Simon took it upon himself to go and befriend the hotel entertainer who had just done the worst impression show I've ever seen. I don't know what he said to him, but after a drunken chat and a hug from Simon, club up my chat here. He left the hotel and folded his 6'7" plus probably frame into his tiny Fiat Panda and drove off with a big smile on his face.
Right, we got. Me and Paul, see, we live a long distance apart from each other, so voice to speech won't always be the easiest thing. We send each other messages about the switch. We obviously have loads of embarrassing stories we could tell about hotel stairways and garden burials and stuff. But we thought let everyone in the room see pretty much, as you've already seen on social media already, some pictures from the stag do. Superb. Yeah. Superb weekend in Barcelona we all had, I must say. So we're going to bring around some pictures. I think I've done this right. It's 1 to 3. If you get 2 of the same number, just show you. Simple.
I've got 1, 2, 3.
Number one, you can all open number one. The first day in Barcelona, we spent a day on the beach on a Saturday. A few drinks and stuff and swim in the sea. Then we're on the big booze cruise.
I know.
Come off the booze cruise and there's a little fella walk around the beach. Here, tattoo. Do you want a tattoo? Do you want a tattoo? No way, mate. Want a tattoo? Hit me with a shot straight down.
No, you're joking.
That is a real tattoo. I'll show you later.
Number two.
I did not know question number two.
Yeah, we don't really need to say anything like that.
We had a flight early in the next day. We had to get up early, but we ended up going through the night, and that was literally like 4 in the morning. Everything was done.
I think it's about 2 hours, 3.5 hours. Finding someone you can live with, it's about finding someone you absolutely can't live without. Ladies and gentlemen, I for one can't be happier that Simon and Beth have found happiness for each other and wish them many happy years together. So please, can you all be upstanding and raise your glasses to the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Kemp. Cheers. See you all later at the bar.
I don't know what to say after those pictures, to be honest. So,
I'm Jack, and as well as being a 1970s Kevin Keegan lookalike, I'm also... Later. I'm also Beth and Kempy's vicar friend. And they've asked me to say a really quick prayer before we eat, and it will be quick, so I know you're all hungry. So I brought along my special vicar scarf, because there's a really old tradition that on their wedding day, couples hold hands, and they have a scarf like this tied around their hands, and then the prayers of blessing are said over their marriage. And this is where we get the idea of tying the knot from. So I thought, if it's okay with you guys, I'd tie you a knot. So if you'd like to stand up and hold hands, I'll come and tie you a knot. Let's pray. God of love, we thank you for bringing these two beautiful people together. And we ask that you would pour out your richest blessings into their lives and into their marriage, that it may be filled to the brim with the deepest love, with the greatest joy, and with endless happiness. Amen. And Lord, bless this bunch as they munch their lunch.
I'm going to go to the hospital. floor once again because it's time for the band to start. So, come this way. Come on, come on, come on. So me and my husband are very happy to have this band here. This is Jordan, James, Ryan, and my little brother Jack. This is Enigma, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm gonna make a little announcement before we start. It's to do with a barbecue. I'm sure you're all happy to know where the barbecue is. And it's gonna be outside at 8:45. Now everybody, you need to remember some things. No matter who you are, no matter what you do to thrive and survive, there are some things that make us all the same. You, me, him, everybody.
That's Dallas. Sue Ellen.
Yeah, you are a big Sue Ellen. You're Sue Ellen.
Climb every mountain high and reach for the stars. Follow your heart's desire, reach for the stars.
And you gotta be so rich for the stars. Stephanie, don't do it again. Don't get down.
Beach, falling star.
Don't get home.
Did it?
Reach for the moon, reach.